outside of the USA that wish to donate to the Eastern Security Network Fund that is based in the United States. Because of the fees that donors have to pay the bank when sending wires, we recommend that if you're sending less than $250, that you donate through the IPOB USA website. It's fast, simple, and less expensive for you. Go to our website, www.ipobinusa.org/donate. That is www.ipobinusa.org/donate and make your contribution. When it comes to keeping our people safe, every bit counts. After all, the security of our communities is our responsibility. Let's make this happen together.
Yeah, Mr. Bella once again. Wisdom, heal it, come on.
Say Biafra will not last forever. They say happy up in August time. What did they know?
What do they know? What do they see?
If you give me a gun, I will shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I will shoot them aside. If you give me a gun,
the lovers of Biafra, Biafra. This is the time we need to come together and fight for what is bigger.
Belong to us.
Ogerugo Maniga, bandits who want to make us a giant of Africa. Adapt coaching team.
Now, hey, Sugo.
Mbogeru Nisina.
Nama Kweno.
Hello, Lisa Binigwe. Out of his wisdom. Giving us somebody like Nnamdi Kanu for this our race to mission. Mission, mission.
Biafra will not last forever.
Forever.
They say happy up in August time.
August time.
What did they know?
What do they know?
What do they see?
What do they see?
If you give me a gun, I go shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I go shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I go shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I go shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I go shoot them aside. Oh no.
See your joke, our hero, how the force never stop. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, but no fun we stop. He cannot stop. Biafra will live forever. Believe me now.
But independence for Nigeria as a corporate entity is not enough. The peoples of Nigeria must at the same time be guaranteed their freedom. We must ensure that in an independent Nigeria, individual citizens throughout the land enjoy liberty, human dignity, and equality under the law. There must be one Nigeria with one constitution and one law for all. Let us therefore, Mr. Chairman, sir, close our ears to the Council of Despair, which says that we cannot here at this conference agree on a constitution.
Mr. Bella once again.
Wisdom,
heal it,
come on.
Yeah.
your pain no go stand. What do they know?
What do they know? What do they see?
If you give me a gun, I will shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I will shoot them aside. If you give me a gun, I will shoot them aside. If you give me a gun,
give me a gun,
I will shoot them aside.
If you give me a gun, I will shoot.
Good afternoon, good morning, depending on where you are watching from. Welcome to this broadcast. This broadcast is going to be very, very brief. I hope so. I hope it is very brief. We're having some downpour here. Now, I've come across some articles that bothers me so much. Sometime, I think, was it last year or so, or sometime this year, I can't remember exactly when, we saw a video that surfaced online where our legend, Pete Edochie, you know, told the world that Biafra is landlocked. So after that, we tried to dozia yonu. Makanabu hoso so onye mwala mwukane dozia yonu. After that, Pete Edochie understand that iho kurono kute here, and we move forward. During the time I was addressing Pete Edochie, our legend, I also reminded him that himself has misrepresented Ndi Igbo. He has misrepresented the culture, the rich heritage culture of Ndi Igbo. And also, I told him straight directly that most of the social vices we are seeing in Igbo land, in Biafra land, is as a result of a negative influence coming from Nollywood. And then also, I cautioned him to retract from those kind of movies that misrepresent us as a people. As after that issue, another thing that surfaced was when he featured in a movie as a head of shared movement in Nigeria. And he came under attack. I think that movie was suspended. And again, I told Pete Edochie, do you see it? Everything is not money. Everything is not business. You don't just put your hand in anything that will bring money. That is not the way to live life. There are some roles in the movie they will ask you to play. You will tell them,
I can't go against my culture. I can't go against my people. You will tell the person who is writing the movie that what you are writing goes against my culture. But no, with all the wisdom and education you acquired, it didn't occur to you that some of the roles you have played in Nigerian Nollywood movie has impacted negatively on our youth. It did not occur to you that everything is not about money. So today, you have become elder and a legend. People are looking up to for advice on how to have a better society. Advice you are going to give will not make any impact. All your word of wisdom, all your inuit to everything has no impact, because the biggest impact you make is coming from the character you play in movies. These are where your impact are felt. And we have seen it in the entire Biafra land. We've seen it in the entire Nigeria. We've seen that young men these days, when you hear Yahoo, it's not about going to do 419 to people, or you know, going to dupe people. Yahoo has become ritualists. Ritualists, people who use blood of human being to do ritual in quest to make money. Exactly what you have acted in the movies. So they believe that there is money ritual. I said these things. Some people agree with me, some people didn't agree with me. So I'm waiting. I was waiting and waiting and waited for this day to come. So it happens that Yul Edochie, the son of Pete Edochie, who knows how they have disturbed him and how long they have disturbed him for him to break silent. He came on social media, and it is everywhere in news media, in newspaper, asking people to stop contacting him and ask where to do money ritual. Why would you be asking people to stop contacting you? That you are just acting a movie. Everything is not money. If you knew that people are going to take you for what you act in the movie, you wouldn't do that in the first place. Because the people that are watching that movie, you have negatively influenced them. Let me tell you people one thing. You don't know. The situation of Nigeria today, some people are ready to die after 10 days. Just tell them that you can make money, you can have billion, and then you live only 10 days and die. Some people are ready to do it. So in fact, 10 days is very far. Some people are ready to just, you know, let them have 1 billion today and live 5 days in Nigeria. That is the level Nigeria have deteriorated. The level. So now you go and start acting movie as with Igbo culture, misrepresenting the culture of Igbo. That Igbos love money, Igbos are ritualists, they do blood money to make money. You have presented the Igbo people that nobody can have money without going through ritual. And one thing is that after you act these movies, the person is going to die in a very, you know, shameful way. And you think that the youth in Nigeria, with the level of Nigeria, the mentality of Nigerians today, the Fulani have finished everybody. You think anybody care to know how they are going to die? You think anybody care to know whether their death is going to be shameful? They don't care. They don't care. And that is the negative influence you brought to the society. So why is Yul Edoche now complaining when people come to him and ask where they can do money ritual? Because that is exactly what you have presented the Igbo culture to be. Some people are afraid of Igbo. They say if you come to Igbo man house, you disappear. Where do they see that? From Nigerian movie. From Nigerian movie. Nollywood. Go to other African countries and you tell them that you are from Igbo, you are Nigeria. They tell them you are a Nigeria, you are Igbo person. And you have money. Once you look good, you look like you are doing something, you know, you look like you are very comfortable. The next thing is that I hope you will not use me to do money ritual. Somebody say, Master Simon, you are deviating. I am not deviating. I am not deviating because this is what we are going to face in Biafra. Master Simon, you are deviating from the real struggle and aim. I must say the truth. Master, since you refuse to broadcast, okay, I don't know where you are coming from. Since you refuse to broadcast in Radio Biafra and you are seriously promoting your own page, Enter Biafra. I did not. I have been promoting Enter Biafra for a very, very long time. Since that page came to limelight over a year ago, I have been promoting Enter Biafra and I have been broadcasting through Enter Biafra. I started broadcasting in Enter Biafra since last year, if I'm not mistaken. I started broadcasting in Enter Biafra since last year. And these are the agents. You know, a lot of people say I shouldn't be addressing you people when you comment, but I'll be addressing it. And then, first of all, I did not refuse broadcasting in Radio Biafra. It is none of your business. You wait until the people who are in charge will make whatever decision they will make. So you are not, well, are you an insider? Who told you that Simon Ekpa refused to broadcast in Radio Biafra? You see, this is how you people will carry fake news. Enter Biafra has been in existence. I started building the page when Facebook took my page down. In May, in April, on April 28, 2020. So why would somebody come here and say, you are promoting? If I promote my page, is it a crime? If I promote my own website, is it a crime? Is there any way you say, when you are fighting for Biafra, don't promote your page? And these are the people who never contributed anything. You see, they don't have name. They don't have name. And they are shouting Biafra, Biafra. They don't have name because they don't have the balls. They don't have the balls to come and fight for what is their right. When you see them, they have all manner of names. People who say they are fighting for Biafra, they cannot even show their own picture. You know, sometimes, you know, when people are saying, don't mind them. No. Sometimes we need to address them, give them sense. We need to address them. You see, you don't talk what you don't know. You come here and gossip with a different name. What is protocol 404? Show your name. Let us know who is talking. You don't hide. You know, we don't know who you are. Fake account. You come and talk as if you are an insider. You know? So, everything you said here is a lie. Enter Biafra has been in existence since last year. And the year is already, and this year is already ending. So you don't come here and start selling lies to the public with fake name. If you are a Biafran, you want to fight for Biafra and you want to comment on issue of Biafra. Bring your name, your real name. You don't hide under fake names and you come here and comment. No, we don't. You don't do that. Bring your real name, your name, your image. Show it. That's how men are done. You don't hide under something and be writing anyhow you want without any fact. So you have distracted us a little bit. Thank you for that. Anyway, so the Nollywood have contributed to the problem we are having both in Biafra and in Nigeria. And this issue is issue that concerns Biafra. Because we are going to be dealing with these social vices at the end of the day. Thank you very much, Juan Uba Diego. We can't be distracted. Mazi 404 is a dog. It's a dog meat in zoological name. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for the super chat. You see, everything we do, I don't, one thing about me, I will not come and start talking something that doesn't have to do with Biafra. This is one of the biggest problems we have today. And this problem I am addressing now, we are going to face it in Biafra. But one thing I thank God is that we are going to have a mechanism that is going to correct something, correct these things. But it is not going to be easy. So that narrative, we have to begin to change it now. And especially when the opportunity calls. You see, one thing is to know when to strike. You don't just come and start talking. You wait for the appropriate time, for the right time to strike. And this is the right time. This is the right time for Yale Edochie to have come and start complaining and telling people to stop contacting him and asking him about where to do money ritual. How can you ask people to stop? Because the point is that the way Nigeria is now, there are people who are ready to do money ritual and die within the next 5 days. So have you seen it? You see that the society, there is hunger, there is starvation, there is poverty, and people's brain are not working. So when they act all these movies, they say, Ndi Igbo man, businessman, and then you see the one that will be very wicked, he will kill everybody, he will be making money with it, he will be making money ritual with everybody, he will be, helping people, giving them money, giving them houses, giving them cars. All those things doesn't happen. We know movie are movie, but these things doesn't happen. It misrepresents our culture. It misrepresents our culture. Yes, Jocelyn, I will start blocking some people. Yeah, that's right. You see, it misrepresents our culture. And when you see what happened in Oba, Kubana, the barrier, you will see that a lot of people are already attaching rituals to it. A lot of people are attaching rituals. This is a very serious topic. Very, very, very serious topic in Biafra. In Biafra struggle, it should be a very serious topic. Some people will be going to that Oba based on what they have watched a Nigerian movie from Yule Doche and Co. And they are believing that these guys that came to Oba, there is no way you can be rich without belonging to one ritual, one occult or another. that it must be, they must belong to one occultic kingdom. They must be making money ritual, and all the girls that are coming there, please don't go there. They're going to use it for ritual. And when you look into it, you find out that some people will finally become victims. Some people will become victims. So, it is not right when you see something that have brought a lot of social vices that we are suffering today in Nigeria, you say we should not address it. If we do not address social vices, what else are we going to be addressing? Because Nollywood has contributed to the biggest social vices you have in Nigeria, especially in the southern part of Nigeria. The social the Nollywood has influenced the student to go into a money ritual. It has influenced traders to go into money ritual. And some of them will end up going mad. They become lunatic because of the negative forces. And the one that pains me the most, is our culture that has been misrepresented. Please, you people should leave that protocol 404. Let him not distract us. He has come here to, you know, when he talk like this, you know that somebody who is hiding under a profile to talk. So please don't allow him. I'm going to block him so that you people will not feel distracted again. Let me just block him. Please, you people, I have blocked him. You people don't need to feel distracted. Let us focus on what we are doing. This is very, very important. When you see people coming to tell you, yeah, we are deviating, that this is not Biafra. Nothing else is more Biafra topic and more Biafra issue than what, than social vices. The thing that brings social vices. And we are seeing it. We are seeing social vices. So what is fueling it? We need to start discussing it from the root. And why I am doing this video today is that the people at that Nollywood, they should start to change the narrative of what they have sold and pushed to the public. They have corrupted the mind of young Nigerians. They have corrupted their mind to the extent that everybody's mind now is in money. Everybody mind now, irrespective of whether you are going to live one day. And you see, one thing is that what people don't know is that when they add these movies, they say, oh, the person will live, and then the devil that give you the money will kill you after a while. So, and you are going to die. Sometimes they say the person will run mad. So they think that when they make that kind of ending, how the movie will end, people will be afraid to go and do money ritual. Well, so why would we be talking about money ritual in the first place? Why do we be making movies of money ritual in the first place? Why don't we make movies that represent Ndigbo invention? Why don't we make movie that somebody, Ndigbo man that created car, that manufactured car, built car? Why can't we make invention of how Ndigbo are doing business, genuinely doing auto parts business, spare part business? Why can't we promote a culture, a movie? Why can't our movie be, you know, represent us, what we do? Business, genuine business. Why can't we have movies that promote professionalism? Why can't we have movies that impact people positively? Why can't we have movie that, you know, give people the sense of innovation? So we are changing this narrative. It is not always your uncle is a witch, your uncle is bad, your uncle is poisonous, he is giving poison, and you go to church, all those kind of nonsenses. And then they want to tell you, from there, you are going to learn how to live in the village. They say, all this thing they are acting here is a true story. True story what? Who want to know the true story? Is that the only true story you know? Is that the only true story you know? What about the true story of innocent? What about the true story of Ifa Nyuba? We want to know the true story of Obi, Peter Obi. The true story of Ojukwu. The true story of Ojukwu's father. You don't know that. The true story of great, 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 great men that have come and gone. What about it? What about that story? Or is that not a story? No, I want you people to tell me, is that not a story? You see, what we feed to the public is what we are going to see. When you feed junks to the youth, you are going to live in a junk society. And Nollywood have succeeded in feeding junks to the society and to the young people in Nigeria. And today, what you have is junks. Everywhere is junk. Young people are going to steal pants of women. They want to make money ritual with pant. There was a time the pant issue ran everywhere. Pant, people, pant are missing. You see? And they want to tell you that your uncle that killed your father is a true story. Is that the only true story from Igbo land? Is that the only true story from Biafra? You see, people should listen to this with a clean mind. So you, Ledochie, coming now to cry that people are asking me, people should stop asking me about ritual. If you are not ready to answer them, why do you go and play a role in a movie? Why do you accept to play that role in a movie? Can I also come to say I'm not a ritualist? Why do you then misrepresent your own culture just to make money? Why? There are other roles you can act in a movie. There are somebody say, Simon Ekpa, go join IPOB immediately. You people are just very, very unbelievable. I am an old member of IPOB. In case you are not aware, I am an old member of IPOB, not just ordinary member. So anybody that are telling you, Simon Ekpa, go and join, I am an old member of IPOB. That aside. Now, one thing people don't know is, why would you, Ledochie, now be shouting in the public that, stop coming to me. Stop coming to me. I don't know what is a ritual. I am just acting a role in the movie. Why would you act that role? Everything is not money. Everything is not money. Now, let me just tell you some of the things that is happening now. You see, there is an upsurge, what we call upsurge of ritualists all over southern Nigeria. Upsurge of ritualists. Young men. Cultist, young man. You see a young man killing his mother. You see a young man killing his father. You see a young man killing his siblings for believing that he is going to use them to make money. You see, the people will think that they want to use it to make money. And at the end of the day, they end up in police. Are you getting my point? They go to some native doctor, and the native doctor who is going to make them rich is very, very poor. Very, very poor. Because the native doctor is wanting to use them, whatever item they are going to bring, for his own benefit. So they tell them, go and bring human head. They will go and bring human head. And when they are bringing the human head, they will capture them. Police will arrest them. Do you know how many people, are you following news at all? Do you know how many young men that have been arrested this year alone with human parts? All credit to Nollywood. All credit goes to Nollywood. All these credits go to Nollywood. Every day, people are arrested with human head. Every day, people are arrested with human parts. What are they using it for? They said they want to use it for money ritual. And the spirit will not protect the person to go freely and come, you know. So these are the things people should understand. And we will not allow it to happen in Biafra. So the mentality of there is money ritual, as Yoli Doche is shouting now, after pushing that thing for many years to the public. So is he going to say that everything he's acting are just lies? And one thing that surprises you is that why did Nigeria government, Fulani government in Nigeria, allow them to be publishing and releasing those videos, those movies? But when it comes to them, shared, they will do everything to stop it. Because they know the negative influence in their religion. They threaten to kill Pete Edochie if they release the movie. Because they know the negative influence it will bring to their religion. They know the negative influence. Whether it was to correct something so or not to correct something so, they know the negative influence that shared movie would have bring to this to Nigeria. They stopped it. But when it comes to you, when it comes to acting ritualist, when it comes to misrepresenting Igbo, nobody will come and say don't publish it. Nobody will come and say don't release it. They have released all manner of very disturbing movies. Very disturbing movies. People are disappearing. People's heads are being chopped off. They collect your intestine. They do this, they do that. They come and kill you. You become millionaire tomorrow. You will be in commanding society. You make this, you all those kind of things. It is not real. Why are you acting it? It is not real. It is not real. Why can't you act movie? How Biafra built Ogunigwe? Why can't you act movie? How Biafrans are traveling and making impact all over the world? Why can't you act? We have so many coming to America. A lot of Biafrans left Nigeria with nothing. Today, they are billionaires in the United States. A lot of people left Nigeria with nothing. Today, they are billionaires all over the world, wherever they are, without ritual. Without ritual. Most of the things, why can't they act a movie that portray the Igbos in what they are, that they help each other without attaching any negativity to it? Why? You see, one thing is that a lot, this movie has destroyed our society. Nollywood movie have destroyed our society, and people who made money from it, especially those who have acted very bad movies. So, my calling, my advice, my proposal today to Yil Edochie, Pete Edochie, Nollywood, is to change the narrative of the movies they are releasing to Biafra people, to the public. I don't even know whether this damage, they are going to repair it, because the damage has eaten deep. Do you know that some people can come to your house now, and the only thing they will look is to check your house, and then next thing is that, I hope I'm not going to disappear, because of what they saw in the movie in Nigeria, because of what the Nollywood have saw. And when they are making this movie, they know who they are. They say Igbo people. Igbo people are money ritual. Igbo people are using their mother for money. Igbo people are using this for money. Igbo people are using that for money. Where did that? Now they are disturbing you. You cannot answer them. So tell the person who is writing the movie, writing the script to you, tell the person to give you answer. At least if the person know it is a true story. So the true story must come from a source. So as you are writing the script of the movie, get the contact of the person that it is true story that it happened to. So that whenever they ask you, you are going to give the number of that person. Say, go and ask him, because this thing happened to him or happened in their family. They are going to guide you what to do. Every time you say, somebody say it is affecting him in Ghana. Every time you say it is a true story. True story from where? True story from where? And the people that try to do it, I want you to go and check the statistics of people that have been arrested in Yoruba land, in southern Nigeria, in Biafra land, of with human parts. From last year, 2020 to this year, you will be shocked. You will be shocked. And to them, they will be thinking that if they had succeeded without being caught, they would have been millionaire. It's a lie. It's a lie. It's a complete lie. Because if they don't arrest you, you are going to run mad. You see, somebody say in Benin Republic here, they are very afraid of the Igbos. Simon, in Benin Republic here, they are very afraid of Igbo, because they said that Igbos used to do money ritual because of the Nigeria move. You see, that is what Yil Edochie and the father has brought to the society, misrepresenting us. It's not only them. And like I said, I'm not here to attack Yil Edochie. He's a nice guy. He's a nice guy, and I like him. I like him because he's somebody who is working hard. But this hard working, you can also choose how to work hard. You choose what to, at least even if you don't know before. If Yil Edochie don't know before that what he was doing is not good, that he's misrepresenting our culture, at least from this video I'm making today, he is going to know. And I'm expecting him to retract. He has made money, even though the money now is not something that, because, you know, it's something that have really damaged our society. So, but he can still be part of making correction. And Kanayo, yes. Every time is a ritual, blood money, billionaire this, billionaire that, as if nobody can be rich without being a cultist, or without being belonging to a one society or the other. You can make money, you can be rich without being anything, without belonging anywhere. And they have made this thing whole everywhere, you know, everybody is now a cultist. It is as a result of the Nollywood movie. So we will start to correct this misrepresentation of our people. Somebody say, but Simon, it created awareness. It created awareness of ritualists. Now, the question you have to ask yourself, the awareness, Chijioke Madubuko, the question you should ask yourself now, the awareness it created, are you going to compare it to the damage? What you wanted to prevent? What you wanted to prevent? Are you going to now equate it with the damage it has done to our people and to the society in general? The damage is incomparable. That is the point. He created awareness to ritualists. Do you know that this awareness they are creating now have actually exposed people to even go into ritualists more? In those days, who know what is ritualist? They say somebody died. They say, oh, he has used his mother to do ritual. Oh, this one have used his mother to do ritual. So if now, what has happened is that even 18-year-old man, a boy, has become rituals. 18-year-old boy is now looking for a way to make money. That is the negative influence of trying to create awareness. What kind of awareness? The negative influence of that awareness is more dangerous than not creating the awareness at all. And that is why I have used this shared movement to give you example. So don't tell me it is about awareness. Because the influence, the negative impact has destroyed future. In fact, we are talking about generation here. They have destroyed the future generation. And believe me, in Biafra, it is going to be very different. None of them is even supporting Biafra agitation. At least openly. Because they have done damages. Damages. Now tell me, when this movie started, where you say you want to create awareness, when this movie started, have you ever seen, like in 20 years ago, or I don't know when Nollywood movie started, but you know, do you ever hear where 18-year-old boy in Nigeria, we have the mind to go and kill somebody, cut the head of the person, and want to do money ritual? It was not possible. But today, it is possible with the help of Nollywood. And you say you want to create awareness. Today it is possible. Do you know that in those days, for you to pick up a gun and shoot somebody in the name of courtesy, it is like, it is, you know, when you hear it, it's like, oh my God. But today, go to school. People, it's small boys are butchering each other because Nollywood. Because of Nollywood. They are butchering people because of Nollywood. So my brother, if anybody tells you they try to create awareness and so it is to create awareness, tell them that the awareness failed. There is no logic there. We have seen it. It failed. It failed completely. That thing failed. So now we are expecting them to begin to retract and begin to save the future because they have failed. That awareness did not work. The awareness has failed. First of all, you don't create awareness by destroying the culture of people. You should be creating awareness how the culture should be, what you should preserve and save the future of your generation and the nation that we are talking about. So now that awareness has failed. That's why I'm coming today. The awareness failed. That is why Yale Edoche is coming to complain. That is why he is now complaining and telling people not to contact him. Did you see that? Are you with me? If the awareness is working and it didn't fail, nobody will go and contact him. If the awareness is working, you will not see the increase and the upsurge of ritualists everywhere in Nigeria. It is because the awareness did not work. Let me tell you, what is culture? People don't know the meaning of culture. But let me just tell you what is culture. Culture, in a very brief and a nutshell, is a way of life of people. That is the definition of culture. Culture is defined as the way of life of people. Now, what is the Nollywood doing? They are presenting our culture, and I call it misrepresentation of our culture. And now, when people are looking at Nollywood, they think that that is our culture and that is our way of life. That's why they are afraid of you. When they see you in Ghana as an Igbo man, they are afraid of you. You are a ritualist. When they see you in Central Africa, they are afraid of you. You are a ritualist because of what they saw in the movie, in Nigeria movie. Because culture is the way of life. So when you see people being afraid of you, you don't know why. You don't know why. The reason is because they know the definition of culture. And the reason also is because they know that what they are watching in Nigeria movie is supposed to represent your culture. So if that is your way of life, then why wouldn't they be afraid of you? Why wouldn't they be afraid of you? Even the people who are watching it in Nigeria believe that what they are watching in Nollywood movie is their own way of life. And that is why somebody will summon courage and go to Yale Edoche inbox and start writing him. Can you tell us how to do money ritual? Can you tell us where to go and do money ritual? Because they believe that Yale Edoche is acting, representing their culture in the movie. And the culture is defined as the way of life. It is, we connect. So you can never understand it until somebody explains this thing to you. So my people, our culture has been abused in Nollywood. Our culture has been misrepresented with impunity in Nollywood. And we must reach and rise up against them. We want movies that will project our culture, what it is. We want movies that will project our intellectuals. We want movies that will project wisdom of Ndi Igbo, Biafrans. We want movies that will project how innovative we are. We want movies that will project our business skills. We want movies that will project how we will go to a dead land and we'll make the land start living. We want movies that will project when we go to a dry land, we water the land, we put something there and it germinates. That's who we are. These are the movies we want to start seeing from Nollywood. Somebody said the movies are interesting. Yes. We want to see this kind of movies. We want to see movie when Biafra people refined oil. We want to see the movie how Biafra did something that Nigeria cannot do till today. We want to see those kind of movies. We are sick and tired of ritualist arm robber talk Everybody, everywhere you see body do the, you do hand like this, do hand like this, you carry God. Babylon, 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 you come here, you know me, it's a Babylon, Babylon. Is that where is that one happening in Nigeria, for Christ's sake? Where is that one happening in Nigeria? Babylon, Babylon. And small children are watching it. Tomorrow they will carry gun and begin to rob people. You see, we will touch every cranny of the society. These are the challenges we are going to face, but believe me, we are going to solve it. We are going to solve it and solve it good. We know that even in Nigeria, we know how Fulani have aided them. Fulani government aided them. Fulani government knows what they are doing. Fulani government know. They don't care. They will just be looking at you. Okay, they release movie now. They release movie. In the release movie, they go. It have destroyed us. They have destroyed the society. So we are not only dealing with all the social vices created by Nollywood alone. Only Nollywood have created a lot of social vices that will take us decades to correct. But it is not late. It is not late. You, Ledoche, that is part of those who act movie, he will also be part of those who will correct this misrepresentation of our culture. He is going to be part of the solution. Kanayo O Kanayo is going to also be part of the solution. So we are officially calling on them today to begin to retract and begin to put mechanism in place to correct the misrepresentation of our culture in Nollywood movie. Thank you. May God bless you. See you in the evening broadcast.